Okay, guys and girls, welcome back to part three. That's right, part try. As you just discovered, we don't have to drive through the river to get to this point. But in order to save us a hell of a lot of time, I am going to drive back through the river because I want to get back over to here. So, okay, even though we don't have to, we could use the bridge. That bridge isn't going to lead me back to where I'd like to be. So we are going to go back through the river. We know this truck's capable of doing it, so I haven't got the fear of drowning it. But, okay, it turns out you don't drive through the river. You use the road. But, hey, lessons learned. So, as I said, this is part three of the waterfall map. It's probably going to take us a while to get everything seen and done. But I have been told that this is probably one of the most spectacular maps for scenery and things like that. So it'd be worth seeing what the rest of this map has to hold. Because at the moment, I don't think we've seen one waterfall yet, but I could be wrong. This is going to be fun. We're going to go back through the river and probably drown the truck. Whoa, that's rocks there. So, let's turn in. And down we go. Whoa, whoa. Whoa. Yeah, I fell off. That's a fair amount of current. Okay, so there is a high bit we can stick to. We should be okay.
Well,
fallen off it again. Okay, we're back through. So you can drive through the river as long as you find the high bit and stick to it. So there's a quick tip for you guys if you're on the waterfall map. Yeah, you can drive through the river, just do it carefully. Up we go. We're going to head for that little bridge that we saw earlier. There it is. If I mess this approach up, we're screwed. Nope, I didn't. There's a log in the road, but that's okay. Righto. Brakes for a minute. Wow, look at that. That's so pretty. Well, look at that bridge in the background. That's just so cool. I haven't seen bridges like this since that Vierdijk map. But anyway, we're here, so we got to go up and out, but I don't know which way to turn. No way! You're kidding me. We can drive through the rock, I think. Oh no, there's a tornado there. We're going to go get it. Okay, we'll go get... Wow. Okay, we'll go see if we can get this tornado without falling in the river. Oh, this is dicey. Sketchy at best. No, look, for a second there, it looked like we had to drive through the rock because the path just went straight up. Sorry for the false advertising. Or getting your expectations up too high. Oh, I found a waterfall. Cool. Okay, looks like we do go this way. Sketchy. More cloaking up here, which I'll probably just go and grab quickly. Rock crawler cam view might be handy. Wow, that's actually harder to get up than I thought. Okay, that didn't reveal anything that the other cloaking areas didn't reveal. Except now, I'm in a cul-de-sac and I don't know which way to go. Okay, turn it around. I guess I don't particularly feel like driving through that waterfall, so I guess we're heading back the way we came, unfortunately. Rocks. And if we're not careful, look at the outflow from that waterfall. Wow. Talk about detail. No way! No way. You can drive through it! Rock crawler cam engaged. Let's go. I'm probably scrapping the living crap out of the roof of this thing. I apologize, but I think you can drive through here. Probably not in a full-size pickup truck. Maybe something slightly smaller. Copping some damage. Yeah. But look what happens if you use regular cam. You're in the middle of a rock. How are you gonna see where you're going? You can't. So a car with rock crawler cam is awesome. You can see exactly what the wheels are dealing with. Now, this is not some mod, it's just a camera that I'm really thankful CCSV Noel has put on this truck. I'm up a wall. I don't know which way to go. Okay, let's head that way. Sorry, that wasn't very clear. As I said, this is beating the snot out of the truck. I didn't even know you could do this, but this is cool as. Oh, bit of damage. Yep, low-lying roof. More damage. As I said, I don't want to think about how this truck is going to look when we get out of here. I really don't. That is a low roof line, and this is a high-rise truck. Okay. Well, we're here. And we have to drive through a waterfall anyway. Cloaking. So let's go on cloaking. Okay, guys and girls, sorry about that. I hadn't realized that the recording software had turned off. So what I have done is I've gone through, I have uncloaked both the points you saw in just the shot before, and look at that waterfall. Now I can understand why they call this map Waterfall. It's got waterfalls, and that is so cool. okay, it's not as big or as impressive as that one on the Swamp Trails map, but still, that's a cool waterfall. And it looks so relaxing and majestic. Now, the interesting thing is if we head back through that trail there, look where it takes us. It takes us back to where we started from. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this rather beaten up shell of an old thing, is we're going to take it back through the rocks, and we're going to go explore on the other side. Alrighty, I'm just having a quick look to see if there is any possible way you can get around it, and guess what? There isn't. There isn't a way that I can see that you can get around where we need to go. So we still have a lot to uncover. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to call an end to part 3 right here, and we will pick this up and we will have part 4. Alrighty guys, so I will see you next time when we pick this up for part 4.